Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to be going over some quality of life tools to make your life just that little bit easier on your journey in Eorzea. You may have been looking around and you may have even found some of these websites and tools already, but without further ado, let's jump right in. So the first tool slash website I'm going to show you guys is this Final Fantasy XIV wiki. You've almost certainly, like if you've ever searched for anything about the game, stumbled onto this website before. I use it all the time. So I used to have this thing where I used to like to know how far I was through the MSQ. So I'd come here and I'd go, oh, okay, I'm on Promises to Keep. I have this long to go sort of thing. And I just sort of like to get an idea of how far through I was without scrolling to the bottom and spoiling myself. But I find it's useful for a lot of things. So one thing it's also really good for is if you're doing your blue quests, or I'd say it happens more in the blue quests, and say for example you wanted to unlock your chocobo saddlebag and you were somewhere in the quest line, maybe you picked it up and you dropped it along the way, and or you're running around and you can't see the blue quest even though it's saying that it's Dosset and it's in the South Shroud, why don't I have the blue symbol? This quest, this website shows you what previous quest you need to have done and what the next quest is. So say for example you can't find my feisty little chocobo, well, then you can click previous quest and see what the previous quest was and go and do that one, and you can keep going until you get to the point that you left off at, or right at the beginning where you might not have gone and started and began the whole chain of quests. But I just think it's a really useful website, and it has loads of guides as well. I thought that this was cool. It has like acronyms, abbreviations and common terms, so you'll see people speaking in like Final Fantasy talk and you might not understand what on earth they're talking about. So if someone said something and you're like, well, what the hell does that mean? So like, what's anima? And you can come here and go, the animal weapons are a series of weapons introduced in Heavensward, and then you can sort of click here and find out more about it, and it goes all the way from A to Z and it's got every acronym you can possibly think of here to help. So this website is really good and you should definitely keep it in your bookmarks or wherever you have your handy links kept, and refer back to it if you ever need to know where you are in a quest line, or have a guide on like a job that you're doing, or just anything. Honestly, it's like an encyclopedia for FF14 and you should 100% use it. My next tool is Lulu's Tools. Now there's quite a few tools here. The main one I use this for is ocean fishing. So I'm a big FF14 fisher. I love fishing in the game. And this website changed my life. So when I first started ocean fishing, I had no idea what I was doing. I had no idea what bait to use. I was always that one in the chat going, what bait do we use here? Because I had no idea. And then I discovered this website. And it's essentially, it tells you when each ocean fishing is. So it runs on an even number. I think it's every 2 hours, I think. And it gives you the route. So there's Indigo and Ruby. And it tells you when the next ocean fishing is, what the objectives are going to be. And here you can filter. So say, for example, you were doing the challenge where you had to catch a bunch of crabs. You could go here, what did the crabs do? And you can see what bait that you'll need to catch the crabs. So if you were in this area in the ocean fishing, you would need krill. You would need krill or rag here. If it has the sort of like glow on the bottom, I think that means it's during the spectral. And this is just during normal fishing. And you can see, and it will even tell you if, you know, there's none of that fish in the area sort of thing. So it's really good. And you should definitely use it. There's also, has all the different areas here, day, night, sunset. And if you come over here and click fish, you can see what fish you can catch in the different destinations and what weather, and what bait you need for each fish, what kind of tug it will be, how many points you'll get. Honestly, it's amazing. and you can scroll through here and you can see, you know, so if you're fishing for a specific fish for whatever reason, you think, oh, you know, could I get that fish during ocean fishing? You can come here and see what route you'd need to be on and everything that you'd need to be able to catch it. Last is the bonuses tab, so you can see all the different bonuses you can get from ocean fishing and how much points it would calculate into. So it's the last couple days of the MOG event. So if you're here and you're still trying to get your 8k points, this calculator could really help you get your bonuses to be able to get that 8k and get those extra points. So this one is amazing, this tool right here. And it also has a light mode if you live your life that way. It also has a chocobo calculator, so if you're dyeing your chocobo and you know you've got all different dyes and you're not sure what it would look like, it tells you the names of the dyes when you hover over them, which is super useful. And you can see what color your chocobo would come out, and it'll calculate it and tell you what you'll need and what order to feed them in order to get your chocobo to change colours, which is super cool. The mini catpot one is also super good. So if you're trying to, you know, get the closest amount of MGP you possibly can from your, oh god, I've put five twice, in the mini catpot every day, you can come and you can use this tool. It is cheating. I don't really use this because I like to just do it myself, but it tells you which row to click on to get like the highest value on the scratch card, and it's super cool. So say for example I went like this, it would tell me to select this one to get the expected value of 2090. So it's a super cool tool if you want to, you know, utilize the best outcome on your mini cat pot. You can also do a name generator for a character. There's a Wondrous Trails calculator here, and all other wondrous things that you can use to improve your quality of life while playing Final Fantasy XIV. If you need any help using these, you can also message Lulu, who is the creator of the tools, because it's Lulu's tools, or this person, I think that's their Discord ID, with any questions and comments you might have. So yeah, super useful. The next tool in my arsenal of improve your life while playing an MMO is this market board website. So here's a pancake octopus. I thought this name was adorable for an octopus, to be honest with you. And you can come on here and see the price of a pancake octopus on each server. So I'm on Light Lich. So if I come over here, I can select light and see where it's for sale in each light server, because you can travel between all of the data centers within your region. So I'm in light, so I can go to Lich, Zodiac, Titania, Alpha, Shiva, and, but apparently the cheapest is in Lich, and that's where I am right now. And Mr. Matthew here is selling it. He's selling one of them for 48 gil. So go and get yourself a pancake octopus before you end up paying 10,000 gil from this person here. And it's just a really useful tool. Like if you're, you know, especially if you're crafting and you really need like something and you just want to buy it off the market board. Another search I did was for a pastry fish. I don't know why. It was just the first thing that came to my head. And you can see what the different prices are in the servers and what the price is on your server. Odin, you can look at all the individual ones and compare and travel to that data center and go and buy it for the cheapest price and save yourself some gil. You don't have to spend £10,000 on a pastry fish when you can spend £175. And it's just amazing. And I was so happy when I found this because it made my life so much easier when I was trying to do my culinarian job. The next... Oh, I hate it when it makes that noise, but I can't seem to make it stop. I was hoping I'd click this and it would mute, but it doesn't. It just plays this annoying coin sound. One time I left this open in like a field of tabs and I kept hearing the sound and thought I was going crazy. So this is a Golden Saucer gate timer. So if you're a Golden Saucer adventurer, you can see when the next gate is in this handy timer, and you can see the time left on the current gate. And it's literally as simple as that. So if you're just, you know, hanging around and maybe you want to go and do something else in the game, and before you go and run into your next gate, you can just keep this open in a tab and see when the next gate is if you're grinding them out for whatever reason. And it's just a handy tool instead of, you know, waiting around outside the gate for it to pop open so you can go and run in. Super useful tool and will definitely improve your quality of life while playing the game. This one I use for my beast tribe. So this is kind of similar to the wiki here. There's loads of information, and it even has all different MMOs, so not even just 14. Lost Ark, New World, Diablo, Last Epoch, which is a new game, so I'm impressed that they've got that on there, because pretty sure that came out like last week or something. But yeah, Final Fantasy 14 is the game we're playing today, and I mainly use this website for my beast tribes. So I was grinding out my pixie beast tribes, and I wanted to know how to get the little Porxy mount, and next up I'm going to be doing the Sylphs. So you can come and you can click the tribe quest guide for the specific tribe that you want to do. You can get an overview, the different quest names, the different reputations that you can have with the tribes, and you can come to the bottom here and see the different rewards depending on what reputation you have with them. I really want to get this minion because it is adorable and it looks like a little Teletubby, and it looks like it's mainly kind of dyes for the Sylphs, but you can also get minions as well, which are super cute, and a little Gobu mount. Now, I know this Gobu mount is controversial because it's a reskin. So the Easter event that's coming up, I'm going to do my next video on that probably next week when the event drops. It's basically a reskin of this mount, and people aren't very happy about it. But I will talk more about that in my next video. So yeah, you can come over here and you can see what different rewards you can get for reaching a certain reputation in that beast tribe. And I just really like the way that this website does it. It's really simple. You know, it separates them between all the different expansions and which tribes are in the different expansions. So if you want to do all the Shadowbringers ones, you can see all the Shadowbringers tribes. So as I said, I was doing the Pixies, and it was really easy to just scroll through and see, you know, which reputation I needed to be to unlock which thing. And eventually I got my Porxy mount, and I had to grind out to Sworn reputation to get there, but I did it eventually, and this guide was super helpful in doing that, and I would have found it a lot harder without it. So shout out to icyveins.com. The last thing I wanted to mention was, in my last video I mentioned this this website for your unlocks, and it does only go to level 50, so this was definitely more for new players, which is what my previous video was about. It was tips for new players. If you've been playing the game a little bit longer and you're not necessarily super new, on this wiki website they also have a content unlock where you can come over here and it goes all the way up to 90. So if you've, you know, you're well past level 50, you're in the 60s, 70s, even maybe the 80s and 90s, and there's things that you still haven't unlocked later on, so dungeons or trials or raids, and you're trying to work out how you go about unlocking those things, you can come over here and you can see the quest you need, the location, and any information that they think was relevant they've put next to it in this little table. And again, amazing tool for just, you know, a quick reference if you're looking to go and unlock something and you're lost for how to work out how to get there or what to do. This is amazing once you get past that level 50 stage, or you can just, you know, it starts from the beginning, so all the way from level 1. But I found this one to be nice and simple to start off with because it's nice and big and the writing's bold and it goes through everything right up until level 50, and then you can come over here and use this one. So it's, I guess they're both really good, and it's just, I guess, down to preference. But I definitely recommend checking out all of these tools and using them whilst you're ocean fishing or doing your gates or using the market board or doing your beast tribes. These little tools will definitely help you. If there's any tools that you use that I haven't mentioned in this video, please let me know in the comments, because I'm always looking for more things like this to make that MMO grind just a little bit easier. I'd really appreciate it. I really hope you found this video useful. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you so much for 100 subscribers, by the way. That is crazy. I have posted like 2 videos and we're already at 100. My goal is 500 by the end of the year, so we'll see if we get there. But thank you so much, guys, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.